Hello, welcome to MedCare Equipment Company's video tutorial of the Luisa Ventilator. The Luisa Ventilator is manufactured by Lowenstein Medical with Movair as the exclusive sales, clinical, and service partner of the Luisa in the United States. The Luisa features all standard modes of ventilation, including TTV VAPS AE, which is the version of AVAPS AE that the Luisa uses. It stands for Targeted Tidal Volume, Volume Assured Pressure Support with Auto EPAP. The Luisa also has the ability to be programmed with mouthpiece ventilation, as well as high flow therapy. The vent has an internal battery that lasts 6 hours when it's fully charged. It does have the ability to connect two external batteries that can be plugged in, and each battery offers 6 hours apiece when they're fully charged. The Luisa has a 10-inch touchscreen, which is the largest touchscreen of any of the ventilators in our fleet. That screen can be used in multiple configurations, so it moves as you move the ventilator. Right now, we can have the ventilator standing up, but we can lay it down and switch sides. So whether the circuit's coming off the left side or the right side, once it moves, the screen will flip to whatever configuration it's in. And the Luisa also has the ability to program up to 4 different prescriptions or therapies. I'll begin to go around the external features of the ventilator. We'll start on the left side here. These two flaps, they look like a little battery. That's where we can plug in the two external batteries if they're available. The next flap is where we can plug in a Prisma Cloud hub or modem. We can use that modem to transfer your therapy data from your ventilator to the cloud to our software, which we're able to see your therapy from our office. And we can also link your doctor so that they can see your therapy from their office. If we don't have a modem or hub, or we just have bad cell service or any number of issues that we can't get that data into the cloud, the next flap is for a USB-C stick that we can just plug a USB stick in there and download your data manually. The next flap is for a nurse call station. So this is only used in a hospital setting. So if the ventilator is at the hospital, the nurses can connect that to their call system so that when it alarms, it would alarm at their nurse station. But again, we wouldn't use that in the home setting. Below, we'll turn it upright so we can see it a little better. The black ringed port is for our power cord, which I already have. The power cord comes in two parts, the cord itself and then the power brick. I've already plugged in to my outlet, but the other end, the other adapter would plug straight into the power cord. These small holes is the speaker. So the vent has alarm set so that we can assure that you get the therapy you need. If those alarms are breached, this is where the sound will come from to alert you. The next port is for supplemental oxygen. So we can clip in a plastic nipple adapter that the oxygen tubing can be plugged into that would go back to the patient's oxygen concentrator if supplemental oxygen is required. Let's go back to the front real quick now that we are plugged in. You'll see down in the bottom left-hand corner, there's a little icon that looks like a power cord, right? And we are plugged in, so the green light comes on to let you know that you are definitely plugged in and receiving power. The top of the vent is the handle to carry it around with from room to room or wherever it may go, and the only two buttons that are used that aren't on the touchscreen. The one on the left that looks like a little bell that is X'd out is the alarm acknowledgement or alarm silence button. So when any of those alarms would ever go off, you can silence that while you troubleshoot to see what's wrong with the bit. The other button is your on-off power supply button. Everything else, again, is touchscreen. Around to the left-hand side, these two port adapters are used for active circuits, which usually involve pressure control ventilation. Again, majority of the patients that we'll use in this vent will use a passive circuit, so we would not use these adapters. This flap on the left side is SpO2. We can plug an SpO2 monitor in there and measure the amount of oxygen in the patient's bloodstream, if that is available. The next flap is CO2 monitoring and nebulizer. We can connect a nebulizer to that. At this point, these two are non-functional. We expect an update to the software in the future that will allow those to be functional again, but at this point they are not. And then you have your circuit connection or air outlet port. So again, the majority of the time we'll use single limb, so we'll only connect to the white air outlet, which would be your inhalation. But it is designed to accommodate dual limb circuits. So again, the inhalation circuit with the air coming out of the vent to the patient, and an exhalation circuit going back into the vent. We will not be using that. We just use single limb. And when a single limb is plugged into the white one and nothing is into the black one, there is a membrane inside that acts like a valve that would just shut that outlet off. And let's go to the bottom. This is your air filter compartment. The Luisa comes with two different air filters, a black spongy coarse dust filter. And a white fine filter. This filter is not unidirectional, so one side is no different from the other side. But once you put it in, do not flip it around and use it the other way. So the white filter always goes in first, followed by the black spongy filter. And then this just clips on the bottom of the compartment first, and then just click into place, and it's back together. Okay, so let's power on and show you what that looks like. We get our power button right here on top. One push, it takes a couple seconds to fully power on. If it's not plugged in, it takes even longer than those couple seconds. Right now, we're just powered on. It's not delivering therapy or anything. Right now, I will plug in our circuit so that we can do that. Along the right-hand side, it says what mode the vent is in. Right now, it's in that TTV VAPS AE mode. And the main thing, once it's powered on, that the patient needs to remember is it's not blowing therapy now. There's start therapy down here on the bottom. We push that. The vent alarms, just to let you know, it's clicked on. And the vent starts filling. So we have our pressure bar. So anytime there's an inhalation or exhalation, we'll see the bar change. what pressures it's getting to, and more importantly, the leak. Right now, I have no leak because I have a nice closed system, but the patient will be using a CPAP style mask on their face with this non-invasive. And there's never a zero leak for CPAP, always sometimes acceptable. We want that leak to be around the 20s, 30s. Once we start with the 60s, 70s, 80s, that's too much then for not getting your therapy. That would involve you adjusting that to get a better seal. Now that we're running, there's a lot more data. That's mostly for the therapist when they come through their big check to document what therapy you're actually getting while it's running. Across the top of the bar, right now we see the machine is locked. The patient can't get in there to the clinical venues. There's a double arrow here. Inhale, up arrow lights, exhale, the down. There's an icon of a person, adult ventilation. There is a child, pediatric ventilation for that. NIV, non-invasive ventilation. And then an icon of the battery and how much percentage. The patient just needs to use their therapy, wake up in the morning, and they're ready to power. Down here, where you click start therapy and end therapy. So if you just touch it once, nothing happens. 3 second hold. Three. And did it make you, are you sure? End therapy? Okay. And alarms to let you know therapy's ended. You can quiet that. Just one push of this alarm silence. But again, your vent is still on. It's in standby mode, waiting to start therapy again. But if you want to power off completely, you'll touch the power button. If we touch it just once, it just kicks it back on again. If you're going to end therapy, 1, 2, 3. Okay. We want to end therapy. And now when we power off, we want to hold that power button. Yeah, there will be an indicator bar. And once it reaches its full bar, it's powered off. So again, I mentioned the data hub. So it comes with a little rubber sleeve that clips right onto the handle. The hub itself slides into that sleeve. And then we're able to connect that modem to our ventilator. It also comes with its own carrying case. So anytime you have to travel with it, it's a nice little divided case to let you know where to put everything for travel. And it also comes with an accessory bag. And I just want to point this out because this is just a bag to carry your chargers in, an extra circuit, any other, maybe the manuals you want to take with you. But you don't want to put the vent in this bag and use it. You always want to allow open space around the vent so that the machine itself breathes. It doesn't bog down and overheat. So again, that the meshy bag is more of an accessory bag. And that is the Luisa ventilator. A quick introduction. If you have any other questions besides what we covered here, it does come with an operator's manual, as well as you can always call MedCare and talk to one of our RTs.